AI is moving incredibly quickly. And today, Microsoft have fired the first real shot by integrating some real ChatGPT technology directly into both Bing as well as Edge. Now, at a base level, there are two things I'm talking about today. One is Bing, which is Microsoft's search engine, which has been a distant second place to Google as far as the search side goes. On the other side is Edge. Edge is a browser which is built from the ground floor of Internet Explorer way back in the day, and is also kind of based on Google tech underneath the hood. But essentially, that is the web browser that is preloaded not only on all Windows PCs, but it is available pretty much everywhere you go. Linux, Mac, phones, you name it. Not only is Edge the best way to access the massively upgraded Bing, but importantly, there are actual smarts involved here. With just a few keystrokes, Edge can summarize a web page for you, write an email, or tell you who the greatest tech YouTuber of all time is. Second greatest tech YouTuber of all time is. Now, the new version of Edge is only currently available in the developer build of Edge for Windows and for Mac. So I've got it running on the Mac right now. You'll also see that they've actually redesigned the UI, which is nice. But the most important thing is you'll see this little Bing button on the right, which will open up the Bing bar. So I'm on my page right now, and say I want to find out, I don't know, what's the most popular video on this channel, okay? Now by doing that, it's going to understand what page I'm on, so it understands that I'm on the Austin Evans page, and then it will then say, okay, the most popular video is Broke vs. Pro Gaming, which has been viewed more than 25 million times. So what it's doing here is it's using not only ChatGPT and the ability to pull from the web, but also it is understanding the context of what I'm looking at. I don't have to just go on Bing.com and do a search. It's built directly into Edge, and as long as I'm asking it about, like, oh, this page or this channel, it will be able to pull that information for me and understand the context. So for a little bit more of a practical example, here's an article from the Wall Street Journal. It's about how Russia's cutting oil output due to sanctions. It's a little bit of a long article. So instead of reading the whole thing, which I probably should, I'm gonna open this up and I'm gonna ask Bing to give me a little bit of a summary. Explain to me why this story is important. So what it should do is understand the context that I'm on this particular webpage on the Wall Street Journal, and now it is giving me an answer in a much, much shorter sort of form, describing that it's used as a retaliation for Western sanctions. That is a very quick and easy way to understand, which admittedly, for this, I should probably just read the actual article. But imagine I'm looking at some financial doc. Maybe I'm doing some research on some long, boring thing that I don't wanna have to read 50 pages of a PDF. To me, this is the main reason why Edge is so much better now. So for some context, Microsoft has invested in OpenAI, which is the company who has created things such as DALL-E, which I'm sure you've seen, which will allow you to type a prompt in and generate a really cool looking image. They also developed ChatGPT, which is easy to forget, only launched a couple of months ago, and absolutely has taken the internet by storm. Now, Microsoft, as a key investor in OpenAI and therefore a top of the priority list customer to get access to ChatGPT and some of the language models behind that, have immediately started to incorporate a lot of this tech into a wide variety of Microsoft products. As far as I'm concerned, the biggest version of this is going to be what you see in search and in the web browsers. So for context, we're out here in Redmond. Microsoft were very kind to invite us out to get a very early sneak peek. So the new Bing is actually already live. So it's going to be rolling out in a couple of different phases. But what I've got access to is the full unrestricted version of both Bing as well as the new Edge. I'll start out with something simple. Who is Austin Evans? Because I'm a narcissist. We've got a few things to look at here. So on the left side, I'm looking at a traditional search experience. But on the right side, it's actually in this little Bing bar. It's telling me a bunch of additional information. Next question, what's his net worth? Let's find out. So as soon as I tap that, it actually moves me up to the chat interface, right? So what you saw there was the search that just had the chat on the side, but then you actually can go and do the full chat. The search results show different estimates of Austin Evans' net worth. And on top of that, it's also trying to cite sources. He gets income from sponsorships and he's married to Karen Evans, who is his longtime best friend. How true you are, Bing, how true you are. Where this really differs from the version of ChatGPT that you can just freely access on the OpenAI site is in not only the language model, which is this is an upgraded version that's been customized by Microsoft, but importantly, this is also online connected. Now, while ChatGPT is very impressive, it is trained on an offline data set from 2021, which means if you ask it what happened at the NBA game last night, it will have no idea. But with Bing now, it can pull live data from the internet. This is a major improvement, but it is not without its downsides. Who are some of the companies that sponsor him? Great question. So right now, I'm just kind of going through the regular flow. I'm learning a lot about myself, honestly. The search results do not give a definitive list, but they do mention some examples of sponsors in this video. Wow, that's a... okay. Name a company or a thing that's ever existed, and apparently I've been sponsored by them. It's literally still going. Look at how long the list is.
Oh my God. You're kidding.
This is all giving you a very early look at the way this works, because I truly believe that this is the correct approach. If you develop this in a vacuum, it's never going to be ready for prime time. So with this, I'm actually gonna give it a thumbs down and to help train the model, because obviously this is day one of this being turned on. Teething issues aside, there is so much that you can do with the new Bing. The way I think about this is more of an addition to search than a replacement. Bing search still exists exactly the way it is now. This is an add-on to that, right? Because search actually does work well for certain things. It just sort of falls flat with more nuanced questions. So if I wanna just know, what time does Chili's open? Well, it can give me that because that is a fact. It's very straightforward, very, very simple to understand. But if my question is, what's the tastiest menu item on the Chili's side? Well, I'm probably gonna have to go and do the search, then click on some articles, try to understand. But here, Bing could quickly summarize some of the most popular dishes at Chili's. I really want some Chili's right now. I could do like 2 3-for-10s.
I feel like since I've started using it, I ask it to make very minor decisions for me, like what I should eat or how to compose an email, because it saves so much time.
Okay, what's an email you need to write?
An email I need to write?
Yeah.
Yesterday it was just like quoting for like a videography project.
Okay, I need twice the pay and I need yellow M&Ms. A professional email, short. Joanna's very demanding, just for the record.
Yeah.
I am writing to inform you that I will need to charge twice the usual rate for our next shoot on Thursday, February 16th. Additionally, I would like to request that you provide yellow M&Ms for me at the shoot. This is not a deal breaker, but it would make me feel very happy and motivated.
My only problem with it is that I personally think the yellow M&Ms are a deal breaker, so.
So I'm gonna take that exact same thing, a passive aggressive email. I need yellow M&Ms, which are not optional. Now let's see what we get. As you may recall, we agreed on a rate of $500 for the shoot, which includes my time. However, I've learned that you've added some additional tasks and expectations to the project. Additionally, I have a few requirements for the shoot that are not optional. They are a private dressing room with a mirror, chair, and table, a bottle of water and a snack, and a bowl of yellow M&Ms. If you cannot provide me these items, I will have to cancel the shoot and find another client who respects my needs and preferences. That's not passive aggressive.
Oh, that was pretty passive aggressive.
That's aggressive.
Can you send me that?
And the cool thing is, once I've made my non-unreasonable and extravagant demands, I can press one button and add it to my email and then send it off, right? Like, this is a game changer. You can also do more fun things. So, give me a quiz on the best competitive Pokemon of all time. All right, first question. Which of these Pokemon has the ability Protein, which changes its ability based on the type of attack it uses? That is Greninja. It's number A, or letter A. I think you're getting the idea here that you can use natural language to speak with something that feels like there's actual intelligence, right? Like AI has been a buzzword for a long time, and everyone's gonna be very happy to tell you why their AI is better. But when you try this, you kind of understand that while ChatGPT felt like it was a big first step, the ability for not only it to be trained on a much more up-to-date model, but also having the ability to pull from the web, pull from traditional Bing, makes a big difference. Let's just pretend for a moment that I'm looking to drop a fire comment on a video, right? So I'm gonna actually ask Bing using the Compose tab in Edge, although again, you can do this with Bing, but the nice thing about Edge is they will actually automatically drop it in. I can give it a prompt, but then I can also refine that prompt. So I can give it the tone. So I'm gonna say it is going to be funny, and the format should be a paragraph and the length should be short, right? So I'm gonna generate the draft, you give it a moment. Ken, you were so wrong about the Galaxy S23. The Pixel is just better in every way. The Pixel has a better camera, better battery, better screen, better software, better price. The Galaxy S23 is just a ripoff of the iPhone 15, which is also inferior to the Pixel. The Galaxy S23 is so slow, so buggy, so ugly, and so expensive. You're just a Samsung fanboy who can't accept the truth. The Pixel is the king of smartphones and you are just a clown laughing, crying emojis. Wonderful.
Is that really what it says?
I'm literally read word for word.
Whoa, so, that's a real YouTube comment.
It's really good,
Jesus,
right?
It's just as hurtful.
This legitimately is an actually real reason for me to want to switch to Edge, because having the ability to not only ask very complicated questions right in my sidebar, but also to get the context from the web pages I'm on. Microsoft have a lead here. right? Like this is, if I'm being frank, probably the first real reason to use Bing ever. I mean, that's maybe a little harsh, but like this is a major differentiating factor. And the fact that this is so good to the point where I'm like, oh, I'm clearly gonna start using Bing. Because yeah, Google might be slightly better in search, maybe, maybe not. It's mostly out of sort of just sheer habit for me. But the idea that I can get that much richer level of information and paired with the fact that if I'm using Edge, I can then generate that stuff and have it easily, seamlessly go into any of the web pages I'm on, whatever. I'm not having to copy paste in and out and stuff. Like, it's a really compelling value. AI, I fully understand, is gonna be one of those eye rolls of like, oh, AI this, AI that. We've heard so many things about how everything is infused with AI. There's a level of truth to that. But to me, this feels like a major moment where things have taken a huge step forward. Microsoft, I feel like today, have fired the first real shot in the AI war, but you better believe it's not gonna be the last version of this battle. And I think if it goes well, which I think it probably will, it's gonna be a win-win for everybody, right? Like, I think we are the ones who are going to be benefiting from this tech propagating all over the place. Like, it being included in Bing version one, great. Imagine when this is built into Windows. Imagine this is built into, get rid of the stupid Siri or Google Assistant, whatever. Imagine you have an actually smart assistant for some of this stuff, right? Like, I just think that this year is going to be wild, and we've just seen the first real salvo in the AI war. That sounds, actually, no. The first real salvo will be in like 2045 when they take over. But for now, let's enjoy it. Let's live it up.